walking's a big deal. And for all these spinal cord injury patients in the country, when they get an injury, the first thing they ask their doctor is, will I ever walk again? And the doctor says, no. And so we said, okay, let's figure out how to tackle that problem. We were working in the space, working on bionics. We actually started working on some bionic prosthetics. And in 2004, there were bionic prosthetics, but nothing existed to help the paralyzed population. I have a picture here. What you see on your right is the bionic knee from a company called Oser that was developed in 2004. And same time frame, what you see on the right is basically a set of rigid leg braces that were used to help a spinal cord injury patient get up and walk. And the doctors were prescribing these things because it's healthy to get up and walk. And when the doctors came to us and said, this is the state of the art of the technology, our response was, well, we can do better than that. To be used in a rehabilitation setting, so it's adjustable. It fits users from 5'2" to 6'2", up to 220 pounds. And the idea is someone comes into their rehab hospital, puts this exoskeleton on, walks for an hour a day to get some therapy and get upright and walking, and then they can trade out and you can get other patients in there during the day. But that's not where we want to stop. This is just where we started. Our goal is to make a device that Matt someday can take home with him and use on a daily basis, really a mobility exo, a mobility platform. So Matt, what's your injury level?
I am a T10, T12 fused.
So where is that in respect to my body?
That is right at my waist.
Right at your waist?
Yes.
So do you have any sensation from there down?
I do have some sensation in my left leg.
Okay.
And a little bit of movement in my hip flexor.
Perfect.
I started using Ekso in December of last year, and since I've used Ekso, I've seen a really more exciting life. I look at life a lot different. I appreciate things more different that I couldn't do before, but with Ekso's help that I'm going to be able to do in the future. So I'm excited just to get it back in the home, or get it in the home so that I can start doing a normal daily life again.
Why don't you take a few steps and show them how it works? We actually launched a new software. So like I said, we started launching these on February 14th of this year, and we've already come out with a software update. There's three ways an individual can actually walk an Ekso. There's what we call first step, where the physical therapist actually triggers the step with a push button. And that's usually how somebody starts out. Then they'll graduate on, once they get comfortable, to what we call active step, where Matt actually has a button on the crutch that he can actually signal the step and take the step. And then how Matt's walking now is what we call pro step. And we have enough sensors on the machine to actually know that Matt has shifted his weight and balance and wants to take that next step. And so it automatically takes it for him. What are your thoughts?